I made a couple of videos showing you how to use a Raspberry Pi 2 as a media player or a great retro gaming machine for your big screen TV, but I didn't talk about using it as an actual desktop computer. There are stories of it being used as just that in the third world countries. After all, that's what it was actually designed for. But what is that experience like? Is it a practical proposition? I have the latest Raspberry Pi 3 right here, so let's give it a try. The Pi 3 is largely the same as the Pi 2 to look at. The dimensions are the same, the ports are in the same position, and that's great as it'll fit in any of the Pi 2 cases that are out there. Obviously, we don't have a lot of horsepower here, even compared to the most basic of desktop or laptop computers, but the spec list is actually very generous for a $35 device. Okay, so let's boot it up. It's pretty quick, despite the fact it's booting off an SD card. Timing this on my watch as it goes. So that's about 15 seconds. That's pretty good. So let's start off with some apps. We'll take a look at the Office suite. They pre-install LibreOffice. So let's go with the word processor, LibreOffice Writer. First startup's a little bit slower, I guess. Okay, so let's quit it and load it up again, just to see, because Linux does cache everything in memory. It should be quicker this time around. Yeah, much quicker once we take the bottleneck of the SD card out of the... All right, so maximize it, and let's just see if we can fill the whole screen here, because it looks a bit weird. I don't actually use LibreOffice, so bear with me. Page width. Okay, so let's just type away. Can't spell. Okay, let's see if we can add a table, just a bit of interest to the document. Nothing too big. 4x4 should do. Okay, so this could be like a science report that someone's writing, or some sales report, anything else for that matter. So I'll just fill in a few headings here. I mean, certainly in terms of going to the menus, choosing these options, adding that table, this seems as fast as any other office sort of machine that I can imagine. No complaints there. Okay, and just fill something else in, just for the sake of completeness. Okay, so let's try exporting this as a PDF. Just a test. Actually, let's put it on the desktop so that I remember where I left it. Okay, so yeah, word processor. I mean, it is what it is. Seems fine. So let's see what else there is in the Office suite. Spreadsheet work's normally a big deal for offices, so let's go with LibreOffice Calc. That loads quite a bit quicker. So I think what I'll do is I'll just create a small table here with just a few values in it, and then we'll see if we can create a chart out of it while we're at it. Fairly common office or school report sort of work. So I'll just put a few names in, put some numbers to it, and we'll just do like a bar chart or a line graph or something. Certainly I'm pretty impressed so far. I mean, I know we're not doing anything taxing, but it's actually, considering it's a mobile phone processor in essence, it's surprisingly good. So. Let me just select these values here. And where do we add a chart? There's the chart. Wow, okay, that's quick. Line chart, let's go with column chart. Probably more appropriate. It's a little slow updating the preview window. Give it a title, oh no, test chart. Who cares? Let's see if we can sort of move it around. Yep, it's fine, it's following the mouse. If I try and resize it on the fly, yeah, that lags a bit. But I mean, it's fine. It lags a bit, but it's fine. So we could print it, give us a print preview. Yes, it does. Calculated that perfectly quickly. I mean, the CPU, if you look in the top corner of the CPU, it's idling, basically. Okay, so let's try Minecraft. I've never actually played this game, but they've pre-installed it. I guess it's pretty popular with kids, and it's sort of creative. Kind of Lego style, I guess. So looking at the CPU again, top right, it's sitting at 25%. That tells me that it's using one of the four cores. So this is not a multi-threaded game, unfortunately. Okay, so this is Minecraft. I'm just doing this really to test out the sort of 3D performance of the graphics. So WASD keys, use the trackpad. I'm using a trackpad, by the way, on a cheap keyboard here. It's frame rate seems fine, wandering around. I mean, let's face it, it's not exactly Crysis in terms of graphics, but seems perfectly fine. See if I can maximize the screen, I guess. I have no idea how to play this game. Let me try maximizing it. Can we get it sort of full frame? See if it's going to... I guess just the window behind that's slightly offset. Give that a go. Okay, we're full screen pretty much. So, yeah, frame rate seems smooth. Jumping up and down, no problems there. I guess that's Minecraft, so looks fine to me. I'm sure Minecraft aficionados will have more to say, but performance for 3D stuff looks perfectly acceptable, as long as you don't want Call of Duty or something like that. Okay, so let's take a look at the web browser, because that's kind of important. And web browsing is surprisingly resource intensive these days. So let's go to the BBC News website. That's a pretty busy web page, and it's not exactly optimized. Okay, loads up. Images are a bit slow loading in. I'm on a 300 meg connection here, by the way, so... Okay, the Pi's only got 100 megabits of Ethernet, but my internet connection is not the bottleneck. So it's taken a while to draw it, but it's drawn the page. Let's click on the article. Still loading. And we're done. Need Flash Player for the video. Come on, BBC. It should be HTML5 these days. So scroll up and down. It's a little bit sluggish, I have to say. Definitely sluggish. If you scroll faster, it just has to redraw the screen completely. It definitely can't keep up. So the browser, not great. I mean, I know BBC's website is not the best one to begin with, but it's not great. Let's try YouTube. Obviously, that's important to both you and me, so let's give YouTube a go. I'm not expecting much here, to be honest. The Pi 2 was dreadful. The frame rate was practically unusable. So it's loading the page in. Better than the BBC, actually, and there's more graphics on here. So let's watch a video. I mean, any video pretty much will do. HD, apparently. That's probably optimistic. That's struggling. I don't know if that's buffering, actually. So let's try 360p, probably might be a... give it a better chance. Yeah, that's better. Wow, the colour banding is terrible. But the frame rate is fine. I mean, it's perfectly watchable. The colour banding's horrific, but... So let me try again on 720. Maybe it'll do 720. I mean, yeah, the frame rate on that looks perfectly fine. And of course, 720 means if someone was showing some text or some sort of screencast how-to video, you'd want to see the detail, and I think that would be fine. Full screen, think it might have slowed down a little bit. I'm not sure. The compression artifacts look terrible, though. Yeah, it's definitely a little more sluggish in terms of frame rate. But it's, you know, it's watchable. It's not great, but for the purposes that the Pi is designed for, basically education and watching some educational video so that you learn something, as opposed to this rubbish, that's perfectly fine. I mean, I can live with that, definitely. Web browsing and YouTube are the least impressive aspects of the Pi as a desktop machine, but they are usable at a push. I think I'd be very pleased with this machine if I was in the third world, or even as a kid here in the West if my parents couldn't afford a more typical computer. I could learn to code on this just like I did back on my Atari ST in the early 90s, as well as play some interesting games. In fact, this machine is far more powerful and far snappier than what I had back then, and it's only $35. If you're looking to learn Linux, especially the command line tools, as well as coding for the command line, be it in Python, C, Ruby, whatever, this machine is more than enough. And the GUI's there to let you code in one window, run your command line in another, and follow tutorials on the web as you go. So is it a usable desktop machine? Well, with the latest Pi 3, I can finally say yes. If you found this review helpful, let me know by hitting the like button and dropping me a comment. And check out some of my other reviews and how-tos. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any future videos.